Welcome to another video of German Autonotizen.de in English. Today I present to you the new Porsche Macan GTS. The GTS is the fourth model version of the Macan SUV range within the Porsche product portfolio. 380 PS. We won't take it on the German Autobahn today as we are in Portugal at the seaside, but still we will have, I guess, enough fun and space to present to you the new sporty SUV. In the tradition of Porsche, the GTS model always stands for the more sporty and agile versions within a model range, and that shall also be the case with the Macan. It's one of four different Macan models. We have the base Macan with a four-cylinder turbo engine, we have the Macan S 3-liter V6 turbo, and the turbo that provides 440 horsepower, and the same engine is mounted here in the GTS with 380 horsepower. But let's have a look at the exterior. We have a lot of black details, like the black exhaust system, we have the darkened rear lights, 20-inch black RS Spider alloy wheels with red brake calipers. We don't see this here. Why? We have optional 21 rims at this test car and the Porsche ceramic braking system, and you see the yellow brake calipers as a sign for that. We also have the side panel in black with the GTS lettering, and also at the front there's a lot of black details and a darkened case for the LED headlights. But we now change roles, and Andy, the guy behind the camera, is now explaining the technique of the Macan GTS.
If you say so, then let's open the bonnet and take a look in the engine compartment. The Macan GTS has the 2.9-liter V6 engine that provides 380 horsepower and 520 newton meters of torque. And when we look inside the engine compartment, we don't see a lot except of that black cover. But what's really interesting is under that black cover, because usually we would expect to see some turbo vents next to the engine. But here Porsche placed them in the middle between the two cylinder heads, as this provides a quicker response time for the engine. And how that feels, for sure we will see later when we drive the car. But first now we take a look at the interior to show you how the Macan looks inside. To get access to the trunk, we open the electric back door. And by doing so, now we get access to the 488 liters of space in the trunk, which provides enough space. We can also see here on the side that we have a small power outlet. On the right-hand side, we have two buttons where we can adjust the height of the car due to the adaptive air suspension, up and down. And we can also extend the space by folding down the back seats in a 40-20-40 split. And now to see how the seats are looking when we sit on them, we now move inside the car and Bernd will take over.
The wheelbase of the Porsche Macan measures 2 meters and 81 centimeters, so it's a medium-sized SUV, but here in the backseat department, it's quite compact. My height is not typically, of course, 1 meter and 92, so I'm quite tall. And contrary to some competitors of the Macan, I have not enough space for my knees here. The driver's seat is adjusted in my seating position, so that means two tall guys need to somehow compensate the space between the first and second row. There's enough headroom. And the seats themselves are very comfortable and also quite sporty. We have Alcantara microfiber and leather combination here, the GTS logo at the headrests, which is also specific for the GTS models. There's an optional additional climate control for the backseat department, so you can adjust the temperature here. We have seat heating for the second row as well, and two USB-C power outlets. If you have smaller kids, you can use the ISOFIX kid seat system, and we have them easily accessible here by removing these small plastic parts. The Porsche Macan is sharing the technical base with the predecessor of the Audi Q5, but still in the interior as well as the exterior, it looks 100% Porsche and it feels like this. Starting with the steering wheel in a perfect position in front of the driver's seat, we have a very thick sport steering wheel. Here in this test car we have the optional GT steering wheel, and the sign of this is, apart from the multifunction buttons, the silver inlays here. They look like metal, but still they are plastic, but nevertheless it looks quite nice. Behind the steering wheel we have the instrument panel with analog instruments, the speedometer and the rev counter. And as in addition to that, on the right side we have a digital display that we can change here in the multifunction steering wheel. So we can use the telephone, we can control the audio, the radio or music from wherever it comes from, the driving assistance, the four-wheel drive, and of course the navigation system, so the map can be shown here as well. We have a car with the optional sport chrono pack here, and then we have an additional button here, the sport chrono modus button. We can go from neutral to sport, sport plus, and we can also configure an individual system. And with that button here, sport response, and then you see a countdown here for 20 seconds the car gives maximum power and maximum torque, for example for overtaking others. In the center console we have the Porsche communication management called infotainment system, which is standard in all latest Porsche models and is very easy to use. It's state-of-the-art connected. We have an online an eSIM card here, so the online navigation system with real-time traffic information. You can use Apple CarPlay, also wireless now, finally, and the display measures 10.9 inches. So it's easy to reach. We have a touchscreen, of course, but still we have a lot of buttons here in the Porsche Macan. For newbies, it looks like, how can I ever control this? But yeah, at the end it's quite easy to handle. We have all the climate control buttons here, so temperature, the air vents and so on. And then it comes further down, seats, seat heating, and then we have the chassis and car control buttons. For example, here we have an optional air suspension in that car, so we can adjust the dampers, we can adjust the height of the car, we have an off-road modus, and in the GTS version we have the sports exhaust system, and here we can activate more sporty, in the eyes of some or ears of some, a more sporty engine sound. Newton meters of torque, as Andy said, they are ready at 1750 revs, so almost every time. 4.7 seconds is the duration from the speed 0 to 100 kilometers per hour with the optional sport chrono pack here in the test car, and the top speed is 261 kilometers per hour. But even more fun is driving on curvy roads like we are doing today. The steering wheel and the driver's seat position find a perfect harmony, and yeah, you really forget that you are driving a medium-sized SUV. It's a sporty car, a very hot hatch or even a sports car, but not an SUV if you would drive it with closed eyes. Of course, you should not do that. Here in the GTS, we have a sports exhaust system, and by pushing this button, the sports button, you hear the additional sound, and that's even more sports feeling with the exhaust sound from the back. Do you really need an SUV with 180 horsepower? I would say yes. When it makes such fun to drive as the Macan GTS. So far, I had the opportunity to drive the base Macan, the Macan S, and this one, so the turbo is still missing, but all three make fun, also the base version. But yeah, the GTS is, of course, the sporty top model, agile, fun to drive, enough power, enough torque, and yeah, it's a nice car, full stop. Also, it's got a nice price, at least for Porsche. In Germany, it's 77,880 euros as the base price. The test car here, fully equipped with big wheels, with the ceramic brake system and a lot of options in the interior, costs more than 110,000 euros. I'm not sure where you are watching this English language video, so I can't provide with all the prices for different markets, of course. Thank you very much for watching this. I guess it's the fourth English language video of Autonotizen. Thanks to Andreas for filming and for explaining the engine. Maybe next time we see more of Andreas, let us know if you would like to see this or if you say stop these English videos. Anyway, let us know. Happy to discuss that with you. And yeah, maybe see you next time. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.